Good morning and welcome back. And here we are again with the next part of yesterday's class. Now today we would be dealing, as we were dealing with nutrition, today here we have to deal with the human digestion. Now as you can see on the board, hope you get a clear view. Okay, now as you can see, the human digestive system starts from the mouth, goes to the teeth, which are also known as the masticatory organ, their tongue, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus. So these are the few basic points where the food touches while it is in the digestive process. Now, as you can recollect that in my earlier classes, I said that digestion of food takes place in four parts. One is ingestion, assimilation, absorption and egestion. Now see, ingestion means, I said that it is the way of procuring food, the way you take in food. So you take in food with the mouth and there comes the teeth. That is known as the basic masticatory organ. That means it helps to break down the food. Now in our earlier classes, we already know that we have four types of teeth: the cutting teeth, the tearing teeth, the grinding and tearing teeth. Now see, the first is the cutting teeth, that is known as the incisors, that is two in number, that is in your front part. I'll deal with the dental formula later on, but basically we have incisors, canine, premolars and molars. These are the four type of teeth. Now first is the cutting teeth with which you cut, so that is the incisors. So you cut your food. Then you have canine, that is present only in the carnivores, not in the herbivores. Okay, so in the herbivores, since the canine is not there and it is replaced by a gap called diastema. Now the canines are pointed and sharp in case of animals, those who are carnivores, especially wolf, tigers. But in human beings, since they are omnivore, the canines are not the pointed one. Now, after the canine, you have a set of cracking teeth, that is known as a premolar, and molars are grinding teeth. Total, you have 16 in the upper jaw, 16 in the lower jaw, that counts to 32. Now, since we have different type of teeth, so we have heterodont, and organism having same kind of teeth is known as homodont. Then you come to the tongue. Now, tongue is basically an organ that have chemoreceptors in it. Chemoreceptors means they are sensitive to chemicals and it can and connected to the brain, and where you get the taste of the food what you are eating, especially bitter, salt, sour and sweet. Now while the food is on your tongue, you can feel, when you are eating food, you can feel some liquid that is secreted from the side of your cheek or near your gum, and basically that is known as the salivary gland. Now once the food mixes with the saliva, it is known as a bolus, a semi-solid clump of a food that goes to the esophagus. Okay, now esophagus, basically that is the food pipe. If you concentrate on the board, you can see that here is the esophagus. Okay, now that is known as a food pipe, and that bolus that is inside your mouth passes through the esophagus through peristaltic movement. That means contraction and relaxation. Then you have the stomach. One thing I missed it out, that when the food is in the mouth or the tongue portion, the salivary gland that secretes saliva or the salivary amylase, it breaks down the glucose in the first and the primary way. Now, for example, if you eat dry rice, without any curry, without any salt and sugar, once you chew it up for a minute, you feel that it tastes sweet, only because of the salivary amylase acting on it. And here is the stomach, and stomach is a temporary storage bag. It stores the food for nearly 2.5 hours or 3 hours until and unless the entire food gets digested. And in stomach, there are certain proteolytic enzymes like pepsin and hydrochloric acid that mix with the food. Now once that temporary storage is there, the food moves to the small intestine,
where it is the junction of the small intestine and the stomach is a J shape, and it is known as the duodenum. From duodenum, it goes to the jejunum, and finally it's the ileum. Now these three cases here, only the protein digestion and lipids and fats are also digested in it. Now you know the small intestine has numerous finger-like projections, that is known as the intestinal villi, and it is richly supplied with blood capillaries where basically the food absorbs. And the lipids and fats that is broken down is readily absorbed by the blood. That is the arteries, network of arteries circulating the small intestine. Now, once the food is, after the food passes to the small intestine, amount of absorption is there. See, first it was there, that assimilation. I said the mouth, teeth, tongue, esophagus, this is ingestion. Now, the stomach and the small intestine, it's completely assimilation and absorption of food. And here, finally, when it comes to the large intestine, you see, basically, it has two parts, the cecum and the colon. And finally, the food moves to the rectum, where it is temporarily stored. The undigested food is temporarily stored in the rectum, and later it is discharged through the anus. Now, see, the cecum and the colon, here nothing is absorbed except water. It is not secretory in function, and since the villi is also absent there. So here we come across the total human digestive system, starting from the mouth to the anus. Okay.